I think a lot of women, and I think it's really, really relevant right now, women who have been delivering, maybe women who have delivered last month, who now can't get outside now that they want to. Mm-hmm. What are signs that you would caution people to reach out to their healthcare provider and their doctor? And what are things that they can do to, you know, to try and manage their mental state?
So the first thing I would say is doubt. If for any reason you personally have any doubt in how you're feeling, you should call somebody, right? Because by default, you know, even if you're like, I don't really know, I think it's just this, or I think it's just that, and blah, call, right? Because what's the worst that can happen? You're like, oh, you're probably fine, you know, or oh, let's talk this over, or let's really kind of dig deep into this, yeah. Versus you just being like, oh, it's fine. And then a couple more weeks go by. Oh, I'm fine. And then next thing you know, your husband or your partner is like, you know, A, you don't go anywhere. You're not doing anything. You're not really talking. You're very like short tempered. You're crying all the time. You know, you get really frustrated, you know, more than normal. You're not sleeping. You know, you're so anxious about, is the baby okay? Is this okay? Are the other kids okay? And what's going on? And you're not releasing control at all. Then by then it's like too late. Now we got to really rein it in.
Would you encourage women to, you know, do everything they can to be vocal and explain to their partners what's going on? And would you encourage them? Because so between after you give birth, right, there's usually a 6-week window between when we get back into the office so we can have a postnatal check, correct?
Yeah.
So in between that time, I mean, for the last 9 months, you guys were really our source of communication. We're always reaching out to you. You're our first doctor, your first contact for anything usually. Yeah. Would you suggest starting there and reaching out reaching out to doctors or your healthcare provider?
Absolutely. I know for all my patients that whenever I discharge anybody from the hospital, I'm always like, you know, I give them the basic stuff, right? Like if your bleeding is really heavy, that's a reason to give me a call. If you're getting a headache that won't go away, that's a reason to call. If you are just unsure about anything, call me, right? Like I want you to know that I am still here. It's a 24/7 business. I'm always available. If it's not me, one of my partners, or nurse practitioner, there's always someone available to answer any questions or concerns you might have. And I think because I do that, more people are willing to reach out. And the other thing is another checkpoint that we have in medicine in general is the pediatrician, right? Because that's the actual next doctor you see, right? You know, because you take your baby. And so you take your baby, and typically, as far as I know, the pediatricians are doing a postpartum depression score on the mom as well. Just a quick like, hey, how you doing? What's going on? You and the baby are bonding well, blah, blah, blah. And if anything comes out of that, usually either the pediatrician will reach out to me and let me know, hey, I have one of your moms here that's, you know, not really doing so great. When can she come see you? Or the patient themselves will reach out to me and be like, you know what? I was at the pediatrician. He or she was concerned about me, so they told me to call you. So I always tell people, don't wait. I've had people wait like 6 months and be like, I still can't get it together. And I'm like, I've seen you 4 times. You have said you've been fine this whole time.
Yeah. Baby blues, when does that usually sort of kind
usually
of stay out?
Weeks.
Okay, so 2 weeks after labor.
Yeah.
So, and if you're venturing into that 4-week period, or if you're experiencing those symptoms that you've discussed,
yeah,
that's when we really should reach out.